Welcome back to the channel. I'm Dingle D, and you're watching H3 Humper. Hey everyone, I just wanted to do a quick update video on my Hummer H3 problem. First off, I want to thank everybody in the comments and the forums and my friends and family who have helped me problem solve. As a recap on my problem, I was having this intermittent crank no start situation. The engine was getting fuel, it was getting air, it was getting spark, the mechanical timing was on. There was exhaust, and there was compression. The only thing not accounted for in this list of things is the computer-controlled timing, which involves the crank and camshaft position sensors. And this was helpful information because the engine that's in there currently was swapped in from a 2008 3.7-liter Chevy Colorado. The work involved in making this conversion work includes installing an intake side cam sensor and also changing a timing sprocket. So this kind of gave me a good hunch as to what might be happening since I got fuel, air, spark, mechanical timing, exhaust, compression. This told me either something was up with the PCM, the powertrain control module, or something wrong with the sensors involved in this computer calculated timing. Considering the history, the previous owner had installed an intake side cam sensor. So here's the spot I'm gonna start looking. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna remove the intake side cam sensor and see if there's any more clues. With removing this sensor, I immediately noticed a rough and uneven mounting surface for the sensor, which I thought, okay, here's something. Peeking through the hole, it appeared as though the orientation of the hole was not centered where it needed to be. To verify this, I headed to my local junkyard where there is a 2006 3.5-liter available. So I removed the valve cover on that one and took a look at the position and orientation of the intake cam sensor, which came factory installed on that head. What I found was that the sensor toe, or kind of the sensing end of the sensor, was positioned much differently than the one on my engine. I also took note of the gap between the sensor toe and the sprocket using a feeler gauge set. That measurement ended up being 0.045 or 45 one-thousandths of an inch. I then took a little piece of paper and kind of stencil traced the mounting surface on that 2006 engine to give me a template or guide when adjusting the orientation on my engine. With this little template, I taped over it and cut it out nicely so I could Sharpie without making the paper all soggy. Stenciled out the sensor hole and saw that it needed to be ovalized a little bit. I used a rotary rasp connected to a 90 degree elbow and my cordless drill in order to remove the material in the sensor hole to properly locate where the sensor would be. With the sensor in a much closer proximity to what the factory setup is, I sanded down the mounting surface in order to properly adjust the air gap, which was previously a quarter inch, and it needed to be 45 one-thousandths of an inch. With everything all cleaned up, I used some gray RTV to remount the sensor and seal it in place. Did a crank variation relearn using my scan tool. Now with the cam sensor properly placed, the computer calculated timing is now accurate and the crank no start issue has been resolved. The vehicle starts every time on first crank with no issues. This is some valuable finding for folks who are having similar issues. If you had a engine from a different year, H3 or Chevy Colorado, and transferred it in, and you're having this crank no start and then start on the second crank, this very well could also be your problem. If using a 2008 to 2012 3.7 liter i5 and putting it into a 2007 or 2006 H3, the timing sprocket needs to be changed, and for the 2006 specifically, the intake cam sensor needs to be installed. I haven't had any problems with this thing now, and I am so thankful. Again, thank you so much for all the help and support with figuring out this problem. I appreciate everybody, and I'll see you next time.